So here's our two update rules, what they end up being. The gradient descent rule that we just derived says that what we want to do is move the weights in the negative direction of the gradient. So if we negate that expression that we had before and take a little step in that direction, we get exactly this expression. Multiply the input on that weight times the target minus the activation. Whereas in the perceptron case, what we were doing is taking that same activation, thresholding it, like determining whether it's positive or negative, putting in a 0 or a 1, and putting that in here. That's what y hat is. So really, it's the same thing, except in one case we have done the thresholding, and the other case we have not done the thresholding. But we end up with two different algorithms with two different behaviors. The perceptron has this nice guarantee of finite convergence, which is a really good thing, but that's only in the case where we have linear separability, whereas the gradient descent rule is good because, you know, calculus. I guess that's not really an answer, is it? The gradient descent rule is good because it's more robust to data sets that are not linearly separable. But it's only going to converge in the limit to a local optimum. All right. Is that the story there, Charles?
As far as I'm concerned.